We understand dissociative identity disorder and really dissociation as a process that helps protect people from really unbearable kinds of experiences and serves to compartmentalize or sequester off really painful memories, painful emotions. And the thing that it does that is different in many ways from other mental disorders is it preserves function. That it allows the person to, and the child in the case of children, to accept whatever nurturance there is in the environment, or the adult to have functional aspects to themselves. So one thing that sets them apart is that they may be quite dysfunctional in certain situations, but there's also areas of preserved function that allow them often to accomplish a remarkable amount in their lives. You can generally pick out sort of some classic roles in most of these patients. You typically have a series of children, child alters, some of which are frozen in time and at particular moments. They're the ones who were able to accept the nurturance and who have good positive memories about the abusers, and then they're the ones who took the trauma and are hold the sort of traumatic memories. And there, some of them are the ones that become the very angry ones and are responsible for self-mutilation and self-injury and suicide attempts. And often there's a kind of, I want you to feel my pain. You didn't feel it, you weren't there, I was the one who took it, now you're gonna feel what I felt kind of quality. There are often some that are just crafted for particular roles that the person has to play in life. Sometimes, you know, occupational roles. There's the one who's the nurse, for example, or something like that. And may be quite functional in that, but when she goes home, out come the little children or something like that. So the rest of the people don't know that. So often it allows them to preserve function or carve up various kinds of life tasks into these different roles.